So what's the difference between a pure strategy and a mixed strategy, Michael? Well, it's simply this. A mixed strategy simply implies or means some distribution over strategies. So in the case of two strategies like we have here, where you can either A can be either a resigner or a holder, we're going to simply say that the mixed strategy for A is some value for P, which is the probability of choosing to be a holder. So do you see what's going on here? So the only difference between a mixed strategy and a pure strategy is that for a mixed strategy, you choose some probability over all the different strategies that you might choose. So you decide that, you know, going into this, I'm going to flip a coin, and half the time I'm going to be a resigner, and half the time I'm going to be a holder, say. Or 30% of the time I'll be a resigner, and 70% of the time I'll be a holder. Okay?
Yep.
Whereas with pure strategies, you always chose one or the other. So technically, it's the case that a pure strategy is also a mixed strategy where all the probability mass is on a single strategy.
Makes sense.
So in this case, we're going to, in fact, choose P to represent the probability for A of choosing to be a holder rather than a resigner. And so P can be 0%, probability 0, or it could be probability 1, or any value in between. You with me on that?
Yeah, that's neat.
Okay, good. To make certain you understand this, I'm going to give you a little quiz, which I have up here on the screen. You ready?
Oh, I see it. It's like those very square boxes.
Yes.
I didn't even realize what this could be about.
It certainly couldn't be a quiz because Charles has never drawn a straight box in his life. I hand drew those, Michael. It took me 17 hours.
Oh, man. You're committed to this, and I appreciate that.
I am committed to this. Okay, so given that we have a mixed strategy and we have a probability P of A being a holder, here's my question for you. In a world where B is a resigner, okay, B is always going to choose to resign. What is A's expected profit? To make it easy for you, I copied the matrix over here in the upper right-hand corner.
Wait. If B is always a resigner.
B is always a resigner.
Then what's, and what is A?
A is going to choose to be a holder with probability P.
Oh, so you want this to be a function of P.
Maybe.
If it's, okay, sure, maybe. It could, well, I mean, yes, it's a function of P. It just might be a constant function that ignores P.
It could be, in principle. Okay. Now, after you figure that out, I want you to decide in a world where B is a seer, B always chooses to see the card, what would A's expected profit be in a world where A will choose to be a holder with probability P? Okay?
Huh.
Got it?
And that's going to be, oh yeah, that could be different because it's a different strategy. Though, you know, seering, like if you're a resigner, you're a resigner, but if you're a seer, then what you're doing is seering.
Mm-hmm.
That would be an anagram of resigner.
How do you see these things?
I don't know. They're just there. The words just kind of mix themselves up. All right. Anyway, I think I'm ready to do the function. I'm ready to stop looking at the letters.
Okay. And go.